Hello, everybody. My name is Sick Joel. So you might notice that my voice is a little fucked, but hey, sometimes it gets like that. I usually don't get sick, you know, but when I do, I'm just incapacitated. Is that what the word is? So I've been, you know, just resting a lot and making sure that my voice was okay-ish for the stream, but you might not really notice it. You might, but whatever. Have you tried unfucking it? There's no unfucking 10 years of sounding like a clown. anyway, hello. I hope you all are doing fine. We're going to be playing a game called Franken RPG. Essentially, this is one of the... I don't know what you want to call it. Earthbound-esque RPGs. And there was one of the things, I saw this on the itch.io page, because it was recommended to me, and I was howling in laughter. You have to see this comment. This is actually a really good game, but I saw this comment, and I was like, dude, I gotta show this. It's the most ridiculous fucked comment I've ever seen in my life. Okay, you ready for this one? Is that a quirky Earthbound inspired dice of baldness forever? What a fucking comment. bald. Okay, anyway. So, we're gonna play in this game, and it's pretty good, actually. It's pretty good. It was recommended to me. It's not a very long game, but it turns out this game has some... extra merit to it, because it's one of the creators behind Deltarune worked on this as well. So we'll see, but I mean, with a comment like that, dice of baldness. I don't know. Anyway, let's play it and see what it's all about. Now, isn't that funny? I promise a Deltarune stream, right? And now it's just like, what? You're playing this instead? Well, I've said this before, but I will reserve the Deltarune evil route for a stream where I can maybe do it for charity or like something special, because a lot of people really want it. And now it's like becoming a juggernaut thing. And I want to really save it for something, you know? And hey, no way. He's never going to play the weird route. Well... I'm playing a weird Deltarune right now. Anyway, let's see. Let's play this game, man. Here we go. Franken RP. I don't know much about this game, man. But a lot of people have said, when are you going to play this? When are you going to play this? So here I am. Doing everything I can. The province of Fentinsenok is in turmoil. Monsters lay in wait through the land, waiting for innocent passerbys to randomly encounter them. What's more, the arrival of the dreaded Hell's Knight, foretold by the scrolls of the Great Wizard Trobe, signaled the beginnings of the Lunar Prophecy, in which the entire world could be plunged into the Eternal Night. It might cause the latest crossword puzzles to become more difficult, but I'd rather not take that risk. That article is good because I'm sick, I can't read all this. The current ones in the newspaper are challenging, but ultimately, if he and real, I don't know what I'm getting frustrated about them. Anyway, King Klebe has sent out various warriors to scout out for the evil beasts, creatures, ghouls, anything kind of like that, in hopes that the Great Calamity Committee can be averted, or at the very least mitigated temporarily, so that it can be somewhere else's problem in the future. I could have done that joke, but I could also play the Star Wars theme. You know. Name the hero. Alright.
Mobius, a great quest of horror and heartbreak awaits you. You must be prepared. Good luck out there!
Okay. Somebody said, isn't this meme over? You cannot kill the eternal immortal vampire, okay?
The hero Mobius travels to the forest where our story begins.
Okay. Okay. I don't see. Again, I'm a little sick today, so I'm gonna have to. The game is so loud. The game is loud. Okay, I didn't know that. Sorry. I don't know what kind of voice. I'm just gonna like make up voices as I go along, I suppose. Today, I have journeyed to this forest in order to seek out and vanquish evil beings. Since it's little here, but slimes, I shall set off and return to town now. So this is Dragon Quest. That's what this game is. Oh, did the person who like drew all the stuff in Deltarune work on this? Because I'm getting that. Look at that little mouse man. Okay, hi Morbius. Great voice, right? Just so you know, your health is fully restored after a battle. So don't worry if you only have a bit of health remaining at the end of a fight.
Go get him!
Okay. Yeah, we got the Dragon Quest slime. Jelly draws near. Okay. Oof. Jams. What the fuck is this? This is great. Get your favorite dancing mode out. We can just sit here for hours and just. I'm gonna turn this up a little bit. What? Franken RPG. That is just for me. What? I'm really sick. With my bars, stars in the sky. Now I'm gonna go die. What? What? Okay. Eminem. There's a new generic dude that can rap, and his name is Yobi. Have sex. Poop my pants. Have sex. What? Okay, let's see here. Attack. I can just do one thing. Okay, so there's definitely a little bit of Deltarune-esque. Okay, we got like old cowboy piano victory theme. All right, Morbius's level increased to 2. All right, interesting. Sorry, this theme is awesome. Joel, did you know Morbius is getting a sequel? I do know about Morbius getting a sequel, and I cannot wait. Let me tell you something, Sony. Sony, if they're actually greenlighting this thing and making it a thing, I want them to turn this around and like make it so ridiculous that it actually becomes like legitimately funny. Like I want it to be like, no, there's nothing is worse like than like a bad comedy, but I'm saying like make it even more edgy and ridiculous, you know. And let's make up some plot points here. How about this? Morbius has a roommate, and there's like a group of friends of superheroes, right? And Morbius is like the wild card, and they go down to the restaurant. Oh, I'm describing Seinfeld. Fuck off. Red Jelly. I watch a sitcom. I guess I just want a sitcom with Morbius. Jerry, I'm morbid up! I'm morbid up! Starting Kramer as Morbius. Okay. Morbfield. Morbfeld. I just made up a new character, Garfield and Mor. Okay, focus on the game, please. Okay. Uh-oh, who's this guy? Yeah. Hell's Knight. Why did the cat go off?
Meow!
You whimpering Weagleton! You've not a chance in heaven or hell of fighting me! You haven't smashed as many new slaves as me!
That's just turning into like a Djibouti Dubs voice.
Hang on. You're having fun smushing those slimes to smidgens. You shit. Okay, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do the Dr. Claw one. Doom Eternal. Doom Man.
You're having fun smushing those slimes to smidgens. You shit. How would you like me to show you what a real battle is like?
Okay.
Obligatory, you have to lose battle.
Okay, Hell Knight. Is anyone winning this? Oh, well, I'm dead. Morbius has fallen in battle. No! You have lost. No!
It wouldn't be worth my time to land a killing blow on a puny little thing like you. I'd be late, like stopping a whoopee cushion. Pretty funny, but at my expense.
Damn, dude.
If you intend on interfering with my plans, I'll not hesitate to kill you. I'll make this world a devil's playground. And pathetic cowards like you will be the swing set.
Goodbye.
Well, shit, man. Okay, yeah. I was so weak, he just left. Damn. Can't believe that. He bought me, man. Okay, if you die, you'll appear at the last place you saved, so you can use the save crystals whenever you can. Okay. Okay. Oh, boy. I'm too pathetic to be killed. Oh, El Scorpion! Okay. Yeah, I keep taking them down. This sounds like Team Fortress 2 music. Okay, dude, I can't take him down. Can I run? Oh, great. Oh, well. It's all over for you, as you have died horribly. Would you like to try again? Okay, well. What's this? Jerry says, I'm fishing in the river. I'll return to town soon. Jerry's so sad. Look at him. Alright. I'm in the castle now, huh? Look at this. Without me, the king would have surely fallen to enemies, yet my house is not even one-tenth as big as this castle. I haven't figured out why yet. I saw this great shit post about oh my god, the big eye Klingon, what the fuck is his name? Worf Killam in Deep Space Nine. Jesus Christ, help. Help me out, please. Gowron, yes. I saw this shit post with Gowron that said, like, millennial Klingons be like, glory to your apartment. Okay, if I'm honest, I'd love nothing more than to see you beheaded. I'm looking out for justification, so you'd best be careful. The king is magnificent, is he not? I'm glad to serve such a well-formed man such as he. My job is for my life to be inherently less valuable than of my boss. I have a lot of self-esteem issues. Okay, this guy's dungeon man. That's a straight-up dungeon man. Look at that guy. Okay, King Klebe.
Dreadful news about this hell's night business. Well, I am better magnificently, don't I? My spirit remains high, for I am a mighty and resplendent king. The jewels on my fingers glisten with my grease from the legs of meat I eat. Okay, Morbius, you will sort this mess out, won't you? If I find you be a meek and blind person, this I shall like emphasis.
I have a bunch of rice in my mouth as I'm talking.
I want to stop thinking about all this. I was only to consider a great body of us.
I can't do this fucking voice. Okay. So on your way, hero. Lead me to wallowing majesty. Mic broke it. Mic broke it. Voice was so bad, mic broke it. Boonsh. Okay. Let me guess, Boonsh is really the bad guy. Okay. Mike Brokey. Okay, what kind of voice did I do? I said I want to do a bunch of fucking stupid voices.
My lord wishes not to be troubled by problems. If anything terribly happens, you must not inform him at all.
Like that, right? Okay, kill Jester. You need to get someone a droopy voice. Okay, so I gotta kill this the scorpion, but I probably need some more weapons and stuff, right? Oh no! We can go down here. A town, huh? A toon. Nothing ever goes wrong here. Nothing. Being an authority of figure is amazing. I can bully people in a peaceful way.
Will you bully?
This exquisite ornate fountain is in the pride of our town. It's a Final Fantasy reference. One of these days I will stream Final Fantasy 1 just because it's so wacky. It's a game about time travel and like a bunch of nonsense. I just don't know if you guys would like want to watch that, because that game is so grindy. But then again, I can just like talk about random shit during it, but I want to do it just to show you like how fundamentally fucked that game is. I mean, I bitch a lot about Final Fantasy 2, y'all know about that. But Final Fantasy 1 is so awesome because it's like the programming doesn't work, and some spells literally are like not coded right, so they don't work. So some spells in the game just don't work. Anyway, Dampy. I love to live in a peaceful town. All right. My son is too busy these days to catch up with me. Do you get to see your own mother often? Okay, today I got into fights and become stronger. Okay, can I read some of the books? No? Okay. Someone had to stream Morrowind and it'll be fine. Okay. Hey, who's this anime expert? Yo, is that Ronald McDonald? No. Sleepy. Beds are 10 gold pieces a night. I didn't bring my coin pouch with me. Sleepy. Duleth. I'm very asleep. Close your eyes. Okay. Is the volume of the game okay? I can't tell. Gertube. As a blacksmith, it's my job to turn molten hot sludge into something cool. When you hold a sword, remember, this used to be hot sludge. Well, look at that. Found iron sword. Okay, how do I equip it? There's not even an equip button, okay. You don't. Okay. Poachy. This is my secret kids' corner. I have some big plans for this space. Uh-oh, villain detected. Okay, let's see here. Grary. Sorry, you're nice and all, but you have the same overworld sprite as my mother, so it'd be very weird for me. Jessipa, you are breaking my heart. This dialogue is special. Very, very special. Alright, well now I have my super iron sword, and I can like take down the oh fuck, what's this? Oh shit, here it comes. Oh, the cat!
Nothing can be allowed to stand in our way. People like this need to learn their place beneath me. I want this town obliterated atom by atom.
Uh-oh.
The world is mine to do with as I please. Mayor, buddy, that smells good, but shouldn't be eaten in my hands. Do you see, Morbius? This is all your fault. Never again shall this town bustle. I can't stop here. I must keep killing. I must kill thousands more. Try and stop me, and you'll die too.
Killing is badong. Okay. I will now stand for the opposite of evil. Gnadab. Okay, yeah. Let me go save here real quick. Yeah. Alright, I don't know if I should go to the castle first, or maybe I should just check on the town itself. I feel like I was very quick to abandon that. Like, not my problem, you know? Bye. Okay. This town is completely destroyed. Aw, damn it. Alright, well, All right, let's take the castle at least. Maybe I can drum up some, you know, hey, help me. Okay, what kind of voice should I even do for this? I don't... You, I, dude, here's the thing. Burger King voice. Did the Burger King even have a voice? Morshu. A King Dedede voice.
I need a monster to clobber that there Kirby. It's giving a Cajun accent.
Okay, no, I'm gonna do John Malkovich. No, I'm not. I'm just gonna voice it as is, cause listen, I am sick. I need a break, alright? I can't be coming up with voices constantly, alright? So, dreadful news about this Hell's Night business. Oh, ha, 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 ha. I bellow magnificently, don't I? My spirits remain high, for I am a mighty and resplendent. Oh, well, Jesus, this is the thing? Okay, whatever. So I said, you're old, haha. Voice act him as a Jamaican. Jamaican. I don't know why that made me laugh. Little Jacob. Okay. All right, here we go. Now I have the weapon to kill the scorpion. Someone said you're making me crazy. I don't understand what you mean. All right, there we go. I'm trying to imagine Joel doing a Jamaican accent. I can do a Jamaican accent. I'm from Jamaica. What the fuck are you talking about? I am the direct son of Bobby Marley, okay? In fact, I've been doing a Jamaican accent all along. Let me switch it off. Hello, everybody. Now here's my natural speaking voice. Let's save. Oh, and a scorpion. Oh, I'm well, bet he's really strong. Hey, who's this clown? Okay, Goblin. So this is the beach, huh? Goblin. Jamaicish. Okay, yeah. I'd love to go to Jamaica one of these days. I'd love to go there and just... I want to, dude, this is so stupid. When I was in New York City, I was looking through the apps to order food from, right? And there's something I've always wanted to try, and that's like real Jamaican jerk chicken. I was dead serious about like ordering Jamaican jerk chicken at 2 a.m. at the hotel. But I like pussied out because it would have been awkward because like, I don't know how to work this. It's probably gonna cost like a disaster somewhere, and they were kind of like knock at the door, and I'd be like, "Who's that?" Like, I don't know how these things work. I don't like, you know, I don't know how Uber Eats and shit works. You know, I'd just be like hiding under my bed. Let's see, it would have been worth it. Next time I'll try real. If Joel doesn't know how the tech works. No, I don't. This is a terrible idea. Drag and draw sneer. Oh, great. Oh, I cannot believe. How could that possibly have happened, huh? Someone said, Joel, are you the son of Bublin Morbly? Okay, listen, my humor is especially bad because I'm a little sick. So, shit is like kryptonite for me right now. Okay, I definitely am, yes. Okay, so there's a really good sword I gotta get there, but first of all, let's see if we can kill the scorpion that's down here. I doubt that. I mean, maybe? Oh, it's a lobster. Okay, different. Okay, the lobster's fine. It's just a scorpion, recolored. Alright, awesome. I've never had lobster either, man. I want to try lobster, but you know, I see lobster at the frozen section in the at the grocery store, and I'm like, that's not gonna be anything good at all. But you know what's funny? You know what's funny with the whole did I forget what the fuck I was gonna talk about? No, lobster used to be like essentially sea spiders. It was like the cheapest meat to buy like 100 years ago until somebody went along and said, no, no, expensive. And everybody's like, ah, oh, that's awesome, man. I'll take that as a fact with no backup of what you're saying. Anyway, so this is the desert, huh? When I was like 9 or 8 years old, then I thought I was the funniest motherfucker on the planet because, like, I started learning English, and I thought I was so funny that the word sandwich would be sand hyphen witch, and I'm like, I was telling my friends, like, guys, sandwich, sand, like, yes, no, you don't understand, sandwich. I guess my humor hasn't changed. Okay. I'm the official Jet Sam officer. It's my duty to collect bits of crap and whatever from the ocean. That was last week, don't lie. But guys! Oh, who's this clown? Condor. You're Morbius, right? The name's Condor. My class is Cool Daggers. I may not look like you very much, I might not like you very much, but I'm pragmatic and I figure out it's best for us to work together if we want to save the world, right? So I'm going to join on your adventure from here on out, whatever you like it or not. Ha! Let's start by venturing into this nasty ass cave. Local gossip tells me that there's a magic shield and that there could come in handy. Nasty ass cave. Okay. Ass cave. There's another town here. Joel's humor then, sandwich. Joel's humor now, gooba gooba! Yeah. Leopard man, welcome to the leopard zone. Goodbye. Welcome to the leper zone. Okay. You know, these leopards don't know. But this is not what a leopard looks like. They're like, I don't know, Thundercats. No, that's what Thundercats look like. My favorite food is meat with a big bone going through it. Despite my stoic nature, I'm a picky eater and whiny about it too. Have you guys been so fucking like, you've been so hungry, but at the same time, you will not settle for anything? Like, you'll be very picky even though you're on the verge of death. What is up with that? I think it's like, this food is gonna taste twice as delicious if it's like good food, right? So you're like, I don't wanna waste it on like a bowl of like tomato soup, cause that's gonna just be okay to eat. I wanna eat like, you know. By that logic, you can just by eating sand, be like, oh, this is pretty good crisp. When it comes to leopard men, I have the most laid-back and humorous personality. Okay.
Leopard man had been very kind to take us in after our town was obliterated.
I'm the mayor of Leopard Zone. I hope you become a great friend to us leopard men. Leopard men. We have taken in these people after their homes was destroyed. This is the way of the leopard men. Oh, they're so nice. They're so nice. Gertrude, I have much to discuss with these leopard men. It seems my romantic prospects with human women have gone to hell. I think I'll see where I can get with these leopards. All right, which one of you guys is Gary? Fess up, huh? Yeah, you know. Yeah, you're gonna make some leopard pucks. Yeah, you... Huh? What? What? Okay, I love to live in a peaceful leopard zone, man. Okay, is he still asleep? I'm more awake than I've ever been in my entire life. Duelith, come on. Have you ever watched Prisoner's Last Meal Request? Yeah, no, I haven't seen that, but I've always thought about that, right? What if could you just make up some shit for your last request that you're like, yes, could I get some C4 soup and a little fish a la hammer? Shit. Really? And can I get a Big Mac and shovel fries, you know? And they're like, that seems a little suspicious. And like, well, you know, it's my religion. I pray to the goddess of Caribbean jerk seasoning, medium hot. Oh, okay, we'll get to that. Do you think McDonald's tastes even better when starving? I don't know. I feel McDonald's is interesting thing, right? I don't want to like dwell on this too much, but I think McDonald's only tastes good when it is immediately served. There's a best before date that's like 5 to 6 minutes, and then it completely devolves. Like the inside structure of the biology of these fries, they get so bad. You might as well not just order it like through Uber Eats or whatever. You might just get there now, you know. Sleepy. My old business is ruined, but I'm excited to see what the opportunities I can create in the Leopard Zone. Don't step on Leopard Zone. Don't step on the Leopard Zone, please. Oh, fuck it. Okay, no, so far so good. Okay, we're gonna go to the nasty ass cave. Okay. I'll give Connor a voice. I'll give the main characters a voice. How should I voice that? Not Connor, it's Condor. I thought Condors was like those big ass birds in like the Neolithic era. Sonic voice. Scottish. He's fucking Scottish. Well, I'm gonna do that too. You know what I you know if there was a voice acting resume, it's a casting call for this character, it would just say Vomit Blast, okay?
Pretty creepy cave, huh? You must feel pretty lucky to have run into a cool guy like me. Otherwise, you'd probably be pissing yourself. Crapping too, probably. Oh. I got your back.
Oh, shit. Piercer draws near. Uh-oh. Well, I got two people with me now. How do I... Oh, there we go. Ooh! Hey, you're supposed to help me, man. Jesus Christ, help! Help! Help, 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 help!
Uh-oh, looks like you're in trouble. I've got this.
Damn, he's so cool, dude.
Wow! Wow!
I am victorious. Thanks, Connor.
Where would you be without me? Well, don't worry about it. It was nothing, really.
Guys, I think Connor's a virgin.
Oh, I'm not a monster ever, a stalactite. I'm just a gray cone.
Okay.
Connor has no game.
Spy, oh, I see. All the mooks are all the recolors. I get that joke. I get that joke. Yeah. Okay. Condor has no bitches. Okay.
Good job neutralizing that threat. We make a pretty great team, right? Together, I reckon we've got a pretty good shot at saving this world.
Okay, I'm voice acting this character, but I'm pissed off at myself for voice acting him that way. I think I have a demon in my head. Okay, yeah. Let's see here.
Gah, I am Blood Man.
I was created to be the perfect life form, but instead I became a death form. How sad. Weep for me, pity me, whatever you do, I'm still a murderer and a ghoul. Come
on, Morbius. Let's put this out of its misery.
I am not miserable. Being Blood Man is awesome.
Oh, fuck. Red Man.
Okay. Hit. Oi, oi, oi. Look at that. Look at these mature rated graphics. I always wanted to like fight a blood skeleton to some jazz. Don't know, Blood Man is dead.
He was so funny. Got him, aren't we great?
Gaha, don't gloat too soon.
Blood Man still got some life in him. Take this, my final attack.
Blood Man runs Connor through with their poorly drawn sword.
That's all from Blood Man.
No. Condor.
I'll be okay. It's nothing I can't sleep off.
I'm really glad we could become friends. We've been through so much since we were met like 3 minutes ago. Let's go. Let's save the world.
No, Condor. No. He never got to tickle a boner.
Condor! Etc.
Found Dragon Shield. Gain immunity to Dragon's Fire. All right. Shit, man. This game is pretty good. I like it. It's silly. What horrible, horrible, horrible fate awaits me now. Joel, you forgot to take his headband. Hey, who are you?
Beefy.
Connor's the coolest. I want to be just like her when I'm big. Oh, Connor was a lady. It was a lady. I thought it was just Sonic the Hedgehog cool man. All right. Okay. Do you know where Connor is? Connor died today in the cave. Okay, well, shit happens. Rip Condor, she never scored. Okay, anything in lieu of the Leopard Zone? Nope. All gravy. Oh, my microphone. Oh, that's good. Okay. Oh, we sure exploring the world here, huh? I'll never forget you, cornhole. Okay. This game is silly. Okay. Well, we're gonna see if we can beat that dragon. Okay, yeah. Probably save too. I will never forget Corridor. Where'd Scooter go? Where am I going? Am I going the right way? Yes, I am. Yes, I am. No. No, I'm not. That's not very observant of me, but... No. It's like up here. And then it was like... here is where... No. Where am I? That's Wario. That's just straight up Wario. Okay.
What?
No. Help me. Blind. No, stop it. I am desperately trying to find where I was. This is Dragon Quest 1? Shit. Okay, wait. It was like north left. No, stop it. Stop making
fun of me.
To the left, Yoel. Okay. No, that... blind, haha. Dude, if it turns out that this path has been, like, blocked off by a stone, I'm going to completely shit out, okay? Was it beach? Right there. And then go up. Up here, right? But that's... wrong. Okay, that's Sid. That's just Sid. Go left more. Okay, dude, I don't know if you're trolling? Are you tricking me? Are you tricking me? Are you tricking? Yeah, you're tricking, dude. Okay, now. Is it up? Up, down. Up here. Okay, dude. I apologize, but you know, hey, you know, sometimes Joey gets sick, and for the first time in my entire streaming career, I have gotten lost. Okay, this is our first time for everything. Okay, and that was my mistake. Okay. Okay. There we go. Well, this should be easy, cause I'm immune, man. Someone said, "Haha, drag on these nuts." What? Drag on these nuts? I don't. Morb on these nuts. What? Are you guys going to E10 this year, by the way?
Eating these new bolas.
E3 was canceled, by the way. Okay. You're victorious. Dude, I will forever be pissed off at that. There's a Half-Life Hazardous Core stream that I did, and I legitimately got, like, Ligmud, or whatever it was, right? Like, it was a sincere moment of, like, fuck you guys. Because I was like, Joe, are you going to, like, SugmaCon or whatever? SockCon, yeah. And there's a moment in there where I sincerely am totally out of the loop with this meme. Because I guess it was new. And I'm like, hey, Joel, are you going to SockCon? And I'm like, no, I don't really go to conventions. I don't really do that stuff. And they're like, fuck it, Joel, what the fuck is wrong with you? I'm like, what is wrong with you? I mean, I'm being nice here. And it just became this back and forth. And I'm like, oh, it's just, fuck. Embarrassing. Goldblade, alright. Please stream Jeff Keighley's gamer show. He's having a gamer show this year? Oh, really? Is he? Okay, well, I'll do it. And I, listen, guys, I cannot wait to be copyright claimed from a gamer show, you know? But I'll tell you something funny. So I'm gonna keep playing here. I just wanna pause for just a moment. Did you know that the Morbius trailer on YouTube, if you show that off, you will not get hit by a content ID or copyright claim? Because they want, quote unquote, influencers to show this, and they wanna be like buddy-buddy. I understood this now. They wanna be buddy-buddy with them, so they took off the license to, like, show the Morbius trailer to be, like, nice to him, right? And now, I was talking about this earlier, but I think they literally just greenlit Morbius 2. I literally think that we shitposted this movie to a success. Because never underestimate, like, bullshit ironic appreciation. And I said this before, but it's either the sequel is going to be the worst thing ever, which might be good. But if it's actually good... Guys, we have saved the industry, all right? I hate the idea of meme-based marketing. What if this guy looks out his window for once? Oof. Yo, finna bussin', sheesh! Yo, these Wendy's fries, they're next level!
Okay. Okay. Here's Dudun. Quaqua, I'm... Quaqua. I'm Hell's Knight, so most beloved little soldier, Dudun. I'm given a plum roll. It's my special job to hold this guy hostage. His airship would be useful to heroes, so he can't be allowed to leave. I've been instructed to self-destruct if someone like you shows up, so now one of the two exciting things could happen. Either we both die, or you defeat me, and the only, and only, I die. Quaqua. This isn't good for me at all.
Oi, 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 the sexy character revealed.
Don't you like my red booties? Let's start the countdown. Oh shit, Now, when people see the sexy video game character Super Mario, they say booba. But what if the character was just boob? Oi. Half as sexy or twice as sexy? But I also say this, why boob when you say boomba? Stupid. Okay, I'm gonna make a joke for 2% of the audience that will get this, but Singy Boogie Doogie! Okay. Balgius. He looks like he's chewing on, like, something in his cheek. Ah, the viewers got that joke. I'll tell you what, though. I'll be right back, sit tight. We're gonna continue playing this, but, I'll just give me, like, 5-minute break, and I'll be right back, so bye! Hello, it's me, Joel's clone, Evil Joel. I'm exactly like Joel. Okay. Did you know that Bouncy Buddy TK is down forever? Oh my god, really? Well, if you saw the clip, on the clip channel, the Bouncy Buddy NFT thing is going strong. Ever since I showed that off, it's skyrocketed. It's actually one of the most successful NFTs ever. It's the NFT of Bouncy Buddy on the surfboard sold for $2 million this morning. I'm just fucking around. I have no fucking idea. Scared ya! But then again, just like Morbius, the irony might just whoop, you know, Okay, how should I voice it? I'm not gonna do Wario, because he's more like Sid. He looks like Wario, but... manly voice. Compromise. Waluigi. Do a high-pitched voice. He looks like the cat with the knife pointed at him. He does! He does! I'm a little sick, so I'm just gonna reserve a little bit of the voices. Thank you for rescuing me from that stupid thing. I became a target for beasts and demons once they caught wind of my airship. I'm forever in your debt. Tell you what, why don't you take my airship? I'm sick of being subjected to warfare, so it's your problem now. You seem like you can handle yourself pretty well, so I'm sure you'll be fine. Good luck saving that world and all that. Okay. Uh-oh. No. Uh-oh. Target sighted. Hell troops move in. Oh no! Oh no! I gotta save him.
Balgus, a decision has been made, and you are hereby sentenced to death. Your crime, disrespecting the sky. The sky belongs to our master and our master alone. You should know your place.
Background.
Your execution is scheduled for now.
I should have known this airship crap would be nothing but trouble. Well, no time for regrets now. Morbius, it's all up to you now. Take flight and give him hell. If you're here to execute me, I'm taking you all with me.
Is that a bomb? You did not come here for a bomb, Morbius.
No! No! First, carrot, and now, potato. Oh, man, my friends are dying. Dying like flies. Damn it. Rest in peace. I kind of forgot your name, but I'm sure somebody at the funeral will remind me of what your name was. Welcome to the air. Hope you have fun flying through the sky so fancy-free. You can land your airship pretty much anywhere except for rough gray terrain. That's pretty much all you need to know. Have fun out there. Obalgus. Alright, look at this. Guys, do you think that Dragon Quest and Final Fantasy had a slight nuance of influence on this game? Be honest. No, not really. Okay. Defeated the dragon, so... Ooh! Who's this? The Great Wizard Trobe! He was described.
You've done well so far to fend off the terrible forces of Hellsnut. For this, I and many others are thankful. You have proven yourself a true hero. However, there's more to this than a tale meets the eye. Will you listen to this old woman's story?
Oh, it's actually an old woman. I couldn't tell by your gigantic pussy beard. My story begins a long time ago. This is the story of the first ever eclipse. The three celestial bodies, the Earth, the Moon, and the Sun, existed in harmony for a long time. The Earth, the incubator of life, the mighty Sun, provider of all the light. And the Moon, you offer guidance and comfort in the dark night. The Moon, however, felt lonely in its position, obviously did not create life like the others. One day, the Moon challenged the Sun and positioned itself between the Sun and the Earth, blocking all light. What is the meaning of this, cried the Sun? Do you not know that
Oh my god.
Remain on the Moon to this day, punching holes into the lunar surface in search of life-giving water.
I get it now. It finally made sense to me. Thank you.
Thank you for listening to my story. I am old and I am to vanish from this world. I trust you to take care of this blue orb. Farewell, Morbius.
Jawbreaker. The blue orb. Alright, that's what I'm talking about. Who's this guy? It's just some guy stuck in the mountain. Is it a glitch? Dev. He's chilling. Okay. Save him. I don't know how to save him, man. Just a little guy. Draw me like one of your French mountains. That's the real Mount Rushmore? The real one? Okay, we got a new island to check out now. Holy shit, what's this? Ultima weapon? Beacon Boy. Or the ARG. What's this lead to? Shit, I might have to call up Jeremiah so we can do the Morse code shit again. Can somebody translate this Swedish for me? I'm not fluent in Morb code yet. Okay, well, it's something. Okay, well, in the meantime, here's this guy. Pots and pans. I hasn't did travel from the far hence kingdom of kitchen, so yond I may studyeth the fighting style's ear. Bid me what techniques doth thee possesseth. My attack is that I swing my sword. For art truly a fascinating warrior. Okay. Kite warrior. I look up to the yo-yo warrior. Holy shit, guys, it's a fucking yo-yo reference. You know, the Mongolian cartoon.
from Hideo Kojima.
I know.
Okay. My own innovation in the field of toy-based weaponry, my battle kite has yet to see much success. Holy fuck, it is a JoJo reference. I was just making a goddamn fucking joke! My walk the dog technique is the strongest in all of the world. Ramber. I was once the greatest knight in the world, and now I am here, on Warrior's Island, teaching the next generation. I'm doing my part to perpetuate an infinite cycle of warfare. Damn, dude. Hey, who's this? Bave. Some might say the mightiest warrior of all is
the ocean.
Damn, that metaphorical suggestion is as deep as the ocean. Okay, so we're at the edge of the world here. I don't think I should be going here. Oh, shit. Okay, I mean, I could try. Oh, we can't even go down here yet. Okay, interesting. Do I just keep on exploring, or do I, like, actually go down on that, like, teleport thing? Oh.
I thought it was like a thing, like, oh, you can only go here if you find another one, and you, like, zoop onto the thing. I don't know, man.
It's hard having my brain. Okay, can't do nothing here. Tower Garden. Oh my, another little hero approaches my special tour. You want to know something funny? Without three magical orbs, you'll be up to Paddle Creek without shit. With that three medic orbs, you'll be up Paddle Creek without shit trying to fight me. Let me show you my wonderful power. Uh-oh. Oh, fuck. It's like that Digimon. Flutemon. Who am I thinking of? Shokumon, yeah. What is this music? It's great. Okay, I thought I could actually beat him, but... okay. That was terrible. Okay, well, so we need three orbs to do this. Wherever can I find three orbs? Where can I find three Morbiuses? Who's this? Mamp.
Yeah, my own micronation, a libertarian paradise just for little old me.
Okay, we're found another island at least. Oh, I found a little cave. Okay, well, the encounters aren't random. I thought it was, but it's not really.
Mimic is a shit.
Okay. I think I still take him down, maybe. Yeah, I'm fine now. Hey. Alright, you are victorious. You didn't level up because Mimic-C refuses to share any experience. Because it has a bad personality and it smells bad. I'm glad you killed it. Okay. That was it?
You killed me! Good!
Really? Nothing else? Jesus Christ, alright. Well, this looks like something. Oh, yes, it's something, alright. Okay, but can I land anywhere here on the grass? Yeah, right. Poachy, this is the kids' island. It's a cool place for kids to get to be kids. This seems like a lot like Hypnospace Outlaw now. Dream! This is where the water park will go. Okay. Here's Befri. I'm worried about the direction Kids Island is heading in. I see the makings of an autocracy and have been branded a dissident. If all we eat is candy and our bedtimes are never, we won't have the nutrients and vitamins we need to become adults. Poacher will be able to reign as leader of a kid's island forever. I'm only 5, but I already have a lot on my plate. That's awesome. Okay, this is back here. What if I go south? What if I go south? Kind of like Joel at 5. Dude, when I was 5, all I did was like ride my tricycle and drink Kool-Aid. I had no problems. Okay, oh, here we go. Oh, found it. Okay, but I gotta touch grass. But you are the same now. No, I switch up my tricycle for a bicycle, excuse you. Okay, 3 man draws near. Okay, 3 man's attack, yeah. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro.
Beep, 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 beep.
Gordon, 3 man. Oh, the 3 man walks away, contend. Oh, he just left. He just left. All right, green orb. Okay, so we got blue, green. Now I'm gonna guess red is the final one, right? I did it out of order, but I don't know what this game. It might be a little funny. Hey. What's popping with you?
Meagle.
I'm exploring the world in search for love. I want to have a wife or to be a wife. Whose chat member is this? Whose chat member is this? Ah, they escaped. See if I can. Maybe some slime. I get to be the protagonist. Shit, guys, somebody call Mike. I know it'd be very unusual, but I'm a very good jelly. It's like, this is a character. Hey. Well, it sounds like you've been through a lot since I last saw you. You have an. You, the red hand chef is air fryer. You have an air fryer now? Such a high flyer. I'm really proud of you. I don't think there's much a mouse like me can teach you anymore. Aww. The reason I turned red is that I have devoured countless humans. Slurp. Don't listen to them. They just ate some strawberries earlier. Yes, but what? What if instead?
You know?
Cause he ate so much yogurt! Okay, what's this? Who's this little man? What's this? Anthem Fighter! Oh fuck, who's this little friend man? Oh shit. Okay. So far I'm doing good. I defeated Atom Fighter. You didn't level up because the enemy was too small to contain any experience points. Damn, dude. Oh, skeleton dudes. Yo, is that bold man? No, it's Paddywhacky. I wish you could have that meal we had a while ago again. We got stranded on this beach for so long that we ate ourselves and now we're skeletons. Right. Was this where I got the 3? Yeah, this was where I got the 3. Someone said, so they stopped ripping off Earthbound to start ripping off Final Fantasy. Cool.
What if I told you all video games are the same?
Okay,
what if I told you that every music is just the same?
It's just
remixed.
Okay, another one of these Morse code dudes. Because remember, guys, Vinny, Yoi, same.
Okay. Oh, I found it. Okay. Oh, you're here already. I haven't really had enough time to get my battle ready. Well, actually, I've had plenty of time. I'm just easily distracted.
Just like me!
Well, I'll show you what I've done so far, if that's okay. Oh, he's lazy. Super breathes an all-consuming fireball. But I have the dragon shield. Is that it? Yep, that's it for him. Alright. Pass. Yeah, still need some work, I know. That was just a placeholder graphic. If I finish my battle later, I'll come to show you. Alright, see ya. Kick ass, man. Hot dog. Alright, well, we have them all now. Is this village still on fire, man? How do you feel about Vinny shitting on kebab pizza? What? When was this? Can somebody link me up? Can somebody link me up to that moment? This is an outrage. Give me a link, please. Please. I am distraught over these news. Somebody's just saying to me, YouTube.com, great link. Okay? No, okay, listen. Vinny did a okay, 3317. I need to check this myself. What in the blazes are you talking about, man? Okay, if this is not just him saying like, maybe I tried, I don't know. But if he's saying like, this is disgusting, then I'm going to like go down to the sea, to the local beach, and go, Poseidon, I call upon thee, destroy all of New York Island. You know, I will be so fucking mad, you have no idea. 3310.
It was really, really good. I don't know if it was worth all that wait, but I've gotten food from there 3 times, and every single time the pizza blew me away.
Is the Vinny sauce making a joke? Because it looks like dickheads, and he's saying the pizza blew me.
So you can see what's happening here.
I sure can.
Yeah. Oh, the corn. How could you make pizza without the corn? Of course.
Honestly, the mushrooms is what I have a problem with. But okay, here we go.
More things on top of it. So. Yeah, I'm not really happy about that. But then again, it's not up to me. People have different pizza tastes. Like in mm-hmm. Sweden.
Vinny knew what he was doing. He was looking at down the barrel of a gun and he said, you know, what if I fire this gun? It might be funny, right? He knew, he saw the bullet chambered, and he's like, I could easily avoid this, but I'm gonna fire the gun anyway. He chose violence, okay? He woke up that day and be like, I feel like being a little tricky today.
So I have a few things that don't work. They're not all that exciting. So this is, I got a folder.
Okay, first of all, I'm gonna say this. First of all, this pizza has many things going on for it. Now, personally, I can vouch and say this. Pineapple on pizza, Banana on pizza is a different story, right? Because unlike pineapple, which is like sour and like a banana and a curry thing on a pizza surprisingly works, right? Now, a lot of Americans in chat are doing cartwheels across the room in anger because of this. But let me tell you something. If you get to Sweden and never try this, if you don't like it, I will personally send you an email from my fax machine saying, taste issue. Okay?
of pizzas from someone, whoever you are, thank you. And this is like Swedish pizza.
No. No, it isn't.
Now, I'm not saying every Swedish pizza looks like this.
I'm glad you added the caveat, because I might cave in your head.
But if it does, fuck.
What?
Okay, olives, we got some...
Oh, okay. These are capers. I see green... Okay, one of the things... I have a bit of a problem with this myself. In Sweden, if you get olives on a pizza, you get them, like, not sliced, and you never get black olives, which is infinitely more superior to green olives, in my opinion. But it's, like, whole olives. However, there's no core in them. They're, like, easily chewable. So it's not that big of a deal. And some people say, like, the taste difference is fucking whatever. It just looks better. Like, a black olives on a pizza looks better, you know? But, yeah. But what the fuck, dude? It's just the pepper... Nah.
I don't know. Is that cabbage in there? I don't know what that is.
Cabbage! Are you talking about the onions? Oh no, oh I see the pineapple. The pineapple is like a stealth nuke. Look at that. It's just sitting there waiting for some dumbass to bite into it and go, you know.
But there's peppers and then there's just wet. It's just like wet.
What the fuck?
Swedish championship winner. Codfish and custard pizza.
Okay. Now we're going on a limb, because now you can say a championship winner, a what, like the fucking brain damage competition? What is this? That's a Naruto pizza. All right, that's not Swedish at all. What are you talking about? What is this? What is this? That's what is this? What is this? What the hell is this?
Whatever.
Yeah?
Whatever, man. Listen, if that wins a championship, how about tape and staples pizza?
Okay, well.
All right. Swedish American pizza.
Whoever sent this to Vinny are a stupendous troll, because they decided to gaslight Vinny, and his audience, which has no Swedish representation, decided to just go with it. Because first of all, Swedish, what? They knew what they were doing, right? They decided to rebrand this for a more impactful what the fuck, you know? They knew what they were doing. Because Vinny has now been colored and so whoever you are who did this, I applaud your stealth missile of misinformation. It's excellent.
Well, those crazy Americans, they sure do love full uncut peppers on their pizza and French fries and ranch.
Now that's on you, Vinny. That's on you. That is on you. Ranch. I want to remind you that we do not have ranch in Sweden. When I was at Vinny, Mike, and I was at a bodega, I put a little bit of ranch on my finger, be like, oh, look at that, that's ranch, it's pretty good. And I explicitly told him I did that because there's no fucking ranch in Sweden. Now, if you have to deduct that, oh my God, I'm getting tilted, I'm getting sideways.
Those wacky Americans. Here's shellfish pizza, and I'm not going to make a selfish joke.
Okay, dude. Vinny, what the fuck? You knew I was gonna react to this. You knew I was gonna see this. All right. What, dude? What? How can you take years of trust and just shit it out like this?
I see shrimp on there. I mean, it's just a completely different thing. Again, if I had a pizzometer, at least some of this looks pizza-y, but I really, really don't want it. And it doesn't make me angry because I don't have to eat it. So, here's one. It's, again, Swedish pizza. I see...
Ask me! Ask me! Ask me!
Why would you just completely disregard me? I am a fucking walking library information, and you took some fucking face value shit that some hobo sent in? Like, hey, check out these Swedish American people. Ask me! I'm right here, you know, fuck!
Bananas. It comes with coleslaw, too. Maybe it's not coleslaw. Maybe it's fancy coleslaw.
Me.
I don't know what it is, but...
No!
Weird choice of topping, but again, it's a cultural thing, I guess.
Okay, first of all, that's something called pizza salad. That's pizza salad, and personally, I'm not a big fan of it because it's essentially just like black, like it's black pepper on a little bit of like coleslaw, and it's not good. I don't like it, but it's called pizza salad. You know, I mean, I
could have told you that, but.
And then you have this one, which
that's Karlskrona. All right, and that is what happens when you get a little too northern of Sweden and people are bored and they're like, how do we like make something that is just completely off the fucking wall bananas because we have nothing else to do? So they bake in a hamburger and fries into a calzone, right? Now here's the thing, right? Everybody can go like, ew, I'd never eat that. But when the fucking curtains come down and, you know, the wee night hours appear,
I want to believe that a lot of fucking you guys would eat this, all right?
Because the same people that would shit on this is also eating fucking Takis Blue right now. And they're eating like 2-liter Dr. Pepper cherry vanilla.
Disgusting!
You know.
Has burger inside pizza, I guess. And then here was Swede Krimis.
Don't cherry pick, because I will go look up American pizza and I'll see a roadkill pizza. I'll see like a raw skunk on some dough and be like, this is what the Americans eat, I've been told. Alright.
So like, I don't know, I see some fish on there, I see some split wieners, I see what looks like human skin probably. I don't fucking know anymore.
This is...
Where'd the pizza music go? Korean pizza. This is real. Is this real?
I had enough of that shit. Okay. All I can say, I'm gonna make a final comment about that. Okay. Now I see what you're saying, Vinny. You're saying, oh, those Swedes, they sure fuck up our pizzas. They're so weird over there. How could you do that to pizza? And I'm gonna say one thing in rebuttal to that. If we have destroyed pizza, what's this? That's my pizza review of Vinny's review. Good night. Thank you. Unbelievable, man. Okay, first of all, I want to say this because the whole reason we talked about it. A kebab pizza is awesome, all right? I don't know what the fuck. Why is this gross all of a sudden? Okay, first of all, a kebab pizza. Let me show you like a good kebab pizza because this is. That's for American pizza. What are you fucking talking about? Okay, so a kebab pizza. What this is essentially, right? You got the gyros or the kebab, right? Then you got a garlic sauce, right? And you have a little bit of peppers, but you don't eat those. You put them off, right? You have red onions, right? And what this is, it's basically a gyro or like a kebab thing that's been like, instead of being baked in like a wrap, it's just outwards, right? How is this possibly bad? Dude, if you're having a couple beers with your friends and you get home and whatever, you're like, oh, dude, I fucking eat one of those. What? This is wrong and bad? Nah, what the hell? What are you talking about? And you know what? I saw Vinny kind of saying, the fries on the pizza. No. You know what that is? Fries on the pizza? That's just... Hang on. Let's go get a picture here.
they're all Facebook links. You can never like look up Facebook things on Google here. Hang on. I'm trying to find an image that isn't like gonna make people go like, ew, right? Like fries on a pizza like this, right? That's just again, it's like a gyros wrap with fries. You know? That's bad. Why is that bad? Too much carbs? You're a clown, all right? You're a clown. How can you complain about too much carbs when you're eating fucking pizza? What, you think pizza's healthy? Or pizza's a fruit? What are you talking about? This is like civil war. What's going on here? No. Simon Patrik, vad i helvete? Alltså det är inte klokt. Alltså seriöst, vad i helvete är det vad som pågår i chatten just nu? Ja, alltså det är inte otroligt. Det är fan inte otroligt. Alltså, det är otroligt. Det är fan inte klokt, det menar jag. Men vad gör det? Ja, men vad fan, till och med Alex i chatten. Vi kärnbobbar. Ja, jag tror fan det. Ja, det är inte klokt där. You seriously would not eat this? You want to try this? It's French fries, gyros, you know. Really? No? What? Hey guys, here. I'm Mr. American. Let me try the Baconator Heart Attack Grill. Now that's food. Okay. Anyway, now that the gaslighting has stopped, we can resume. Unbelievable, guys. This hurts me. This hurts me. So for what it's worth, I've had potato and pizza before. It wasn't great, wasn't bad. Alright, listen here, you fucking people. You come fucking in my chat and tell me what you can fucking can't do. Oh, guys, did you know that the Swedish people, oh my god, did you know that the Swedish people put French fries on pizza, right? Did you know? They're so crazy over there. Oi, so crazy. Oh, they're so disgusting over there. Oi, they're so crazy over there, dude. Pizza war, everybody. Pizza war. Well, you know, I'll say this. If Vinny wants a clip back, I'll just say this to him, right? I respect your opinion and misinformation about Swedish pizza, but again, opinions are like assholes, and you're stink. Thank you for the pizza conversation. Good night. Okay, yeah. Anyway, back to our regular scheduled shit. Okay, yeah. So I said, what the actual PP is this? This right here? I don't know, it might be chemical warfare. I'm not sure what it is, but all right. Anyway, back to the video game. Anyway. So, we have all the orbs now. Yes, how long was this bit? Way too long. Okay. Well, I know where this is at least. Joel, Americans cannot judge when we deep fry Oreos. How dare you, Americans don't do that. That's a Scottish, right? Okay. The game is a bit by this point. Can you say about Franken RPGs, please? It's made by one of the developers behind Deltarune, and they just made like this one-off Final Fantasy Dragon Quest parody, essentially, and it's pretty good. It's making me laugh. Okay. Well, here are my three orbs. Here we go.
Oh my, another little hero approaches my special tower. You want to know something funny? Yeah. Uh-oh. Power of the three orbs combined together to smite your foe. Instantly, son. This seems like an anime theme from something. Like Mazinga or like what's that battleship Yamato? Like it sounds straight out of that. It is, I think. Is it? It's from Yamato. Really? Alright. Alright, well, there we go. Pretty good. Excellent! You are the winner of killing me. If anyone asks, tell them I was just protecting you, okay? I'm really Morbius Guardian. You see, because if you go inside the tower, you'll die. You're like a baby trying to get into a cabinet full of deadly chemicals. I'm sorry that I couldn't protect you. Damn, he's smart. Okay. Oh boy. This is, dude, I hope this isn't gonna be blocked in Germany or... It's him. Killer Robo draws near. Okay, I was gonna mention something in Final Fantasy 1. The strongest enemy in Final Fantasy 1 is a robot called like Mecha Kill or something like that. And he's so strong, he might as well be like what later Final Fantasy games refer to as like extra bosses or whatever. Like that Warmech will stomp on your testicles, man. He won't apologize for it. It's ridiculous. I gotta say, I love this music even though it's like stolen from somewhere. Supposedly. It's lovely. I did it! You are victorious. Guys, I can't stop thinking about Potato, whatever the guy's name was. I see. A force field blocks the way. Right. A missile. Missile draws near. Okay. Well, I'm pretty strong here. I don't need to worry too much. Because my health is regained every time, which is pretty good. Am I supposed to grind in this area? I'm not sure. Yeah. You know, I was thinking about something the other day. How ugly, like, Undertale's, like, world graphics are compared to, like, Deltarune. I mean, it's not ugly, but by comparison, Deltarune looks so much nicer. And I'm thinking, like, this area is very much like, what the fuck is it called? The lava area. It's very, like, it's very just as is. The core, yeah. But it's also for, like, a sort of ironic effect. Oh my god. Who's that? Dr. Heckle.
It's really quite trouble. Hellblast brings even the corpses I harvest them for organs and pickle them in these tubes and use to make all sorts of effed up things. Yes, life doesn't get better than these.
Okay. Ooh, what does this button do? You heard a force field deactivate in distance, whatever that sounds like. You're gonna fight me? Alright. Undertale was just Toby warming up to make Delta runes anyway. That's a bit of a fucking warm-up, huh? Okay, yeah. Dr. Utker pizza review right now? I did that already. I did a pizza review on a tier list to make a thing. Oh no, puzzles! Could the Joey do it? Oh my god. Wait a minute. That card. He doing it. I cannot believe.
Wrong hole, Joey.
How did he do it? He must have read the game facts for this.
You heard the all-too-familiar sound of a force field deactivating in the distance.
Wow.
The dog. Is he ready now? Hey, it's me again. I made a bit of a progress since last time we met. Here's what I've done of my battle graphics so far. It's coming along pretty well. Truth be told, though, I don't actually really want to finish it. Like, it's fine and all that. Don't get me wrong, but I'm just not feeling it. I think I need to reevaluate what makes me happy when making art, you know? I hope you understand. Get better soon, dog. Okay, yeah. Well, goodbye. Yo, listen, you want to hear something from the pros, right? When I was 9, I learned something incredible, right? You can become any artist on the planet, and you can do a better job at what they've done, right? Here's what you do, right? You take a picture on the internet, right? And then you put it down. And then you take a piece of paper, and on top of that, you draw what the other person did, right? But hear me out. You can make Goku green. Akira Toriyama is yesterday's news. Stan Lee? I don't think Stan Lee actually drew, but... Stan Lee? Don't think so. I'm just saying, guys. Akira Toriyama? Going up. Oh shit, we're going fast. We're going fast up the elevator. Oh, I'm fine. Okay, level 99999. Okay. Oh, save point. Our master's trying to create life as machines. We were not good enough. Dejection really hurt the feelings I don't have. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh boy.
The stars look especially beautiful tonight. Shining over this bloodstained land. The land is bleeding and crying and screaming and shitting and coming. And now it needs a bandage. I think you are the bandage this land needs, Morbius. The bandage that protects the wounds of this world from infection.
Sorry, I threw him off. Oh, the cat!
The bandage that comes off in the swimming pool. The scabby bandage that floats around in the water, grossing everyone out. That's you. That's all you are to me. Scum, filth,
detritus.
You only managed to make it up here because disgusting froth like you always floats to the top. Something as lowly as you must be impressed by all this, though, right? My master has some amazing plans. All I'd do in exchange for the great power I wield was to kill thousands of people. You'll be the
1238th
person I kill. Not even a big milestone or anything. And the
1284th
will be my master. I'm sick of being someone else's pawn. Standing up here, I've thought about a lot of things, and I've come to realize being the ruler of the whole world will suit me. You can watch me take my throne from your grave.
Time to die, Morbius.
Oh shit.
This is the end for you. Prepare to be slaughtered.
Okay, well.
Oh, look at you. You actually managed to damage me this time. Consider me impressed. When I look back on this, I'll remember fondly the time I got scratched a little bit by someone I crushed into a meaty paste.
Well.
Accept that this is where you perish, Morbius. Fall into an endless nap time without dreams.
Hey, Fist of the North Star reference, I know that.
You are nothing to me but a measly head louse. little more than an irritating itch on my scalp that deserves to be drowned by a special shampoo and combed away into nothingness.
Did anyone realize that shampoo has the word sham in it?
While you're still trying, anyone can look at our respective health HP points, heart bars, and see you can't win.
Uh-oh.
Condor! Condor! Will Condor save me?
With this final attack, your sad little story will come to a miserable end. Any last words, Morbius?
Yeah. Just two. More in time.
Nothing much to say, huh? Well, I'll grant you a hero's death, being cleaved into chunks and fed to the ducks. Farewell, Morbius.
Uh-oh.
Huh? Did my attack miss or something? I want nothing more than to strike you down. Something like this should not happen.
Uh-oh.
It's the power of love.
What again? What's happening to me? I can feel myself holding back. Why? You're sick, Morbius.
Are you a doctor?
I am a doctor.
What have you done to me? You're making me feel horrid. You're a truly horrible person for doing this to me. Ah.
Me and some people have my disease.
Uh-oh. I'm seething with rage. Why can't I do anything? You shit from the sewer! How dare you? Stop this. I want you to be dead. I want you to stop being alive.
Damn. He's gonna take off his helmet. And it's gonna be bald. And then we know.
No, I'm crying. Why? I can't take this anymore. I'm terrified beyond belief. I won't let you get away with this. I'll kill you. I'll kill you. And I'll kill you. I'll piss myself. I'll kill you. I'll...
Oh no, secret ending. Can I not kill? Do I have to kill?
As corpus. I can't do that. I gotta do this.
No. What? I failed. Why won't you put me to the sword?
It's over. I know who you are. And I think you know who I am too.
I do. Everything is coming back to me. When I became Hell's Knight.
Not Hell's Knight.
My memories were taken from me. I remember you, Morbius. I remember our childhood together. I'm...
I'm Chibi! I was your beloved childhood doll. I'm sorry about everything.
It's okay. It's my fault, too. I should have never whispered all those swear words to you while we played.
I've done so many terrible things. But in my defense, I got turned into a badass and evil knight. After you grew up, all I wanted was a chance to have a life of my own. Someone from the moon appeared and so forget me. The one who did this to me, my name is Eclipsion.
Oh, maybe I should have paid attention to that witch story. Whatever.
If we go up with the moon together, we could team up and defeat them. And after all this, maybe we can be friends and play together one more time. I hope that I can learn to be alive even when I'm away from you.
Okay.
Thank you, Morbius. This circle thing will transport us to the moon. I'll go first. I'll see you there.
Wow. Hey, your master's dead. Okay, maybe I gotta go with him. Well, off we go. Uh-oh. He's probably gonna die. No! Don't tell me these things. We're on the moon now.
Chibi, where are you? I'm sorry to tell you this, but Chibi's no more. What? What happened to Chibi? Well, it's very simple. I heard all about Chibi plotting to betray me from up here. I didn't much care for that, so I had to teleport vaporize them. No! They're little more than atoms now! Oh, they stopped being Hell's Knight. I only cared about them at all when they were Hell's Knight. You, however, are quite interesting to me. I'd love ever so much to meet you. I'm sure you've been wondering what all this has been for. My dreams are this close to being realized. So come and find me at my moon castle, Morbius. I'm waiting there just for you. Oh, fuck it.
Got moon jams, though.
Let me guess, if I go far, I will find an Easter egg or something like that, right?
A moon trees.
Okay, yeah. Hey, what's this? What's this? Just an eye. Hey guys, you're finally getting that Yume Nikki stream. Okay, or maybe this leads to the castle itself. Yes, yes, it does. It really does look like Yume Nikki. All right. Well, I guess you head inside. What is this? Oh God! Is it gonna be a Kirby final boss, like a giant eyeball or something like that? But it got jams. It's got jams. Oof. Oof. Okay, we got a regular knight now. Moon Warrior Grossner here. Okay, he's the same thing, but whatever. Crazy Bus theme. It sounds a little crazy bussy, yeah. Crazy bussy? I gotta wash my fucking mouth. Okay, what's this? Bussy. Okay, yeah. Interesting. Okay, yeah. You got a feeling that once you cross the rainbow, you won't be able to return. Right. Oof, what jams, man? Point on return. Here we go. Oh, what a theme, man. Is this original music? It's fantastic. Okay, yeah. Interesting. Well, we are on the moon. Is this some sort of Majora's Mask thing going on here, or... Oh boy, what's this? Oh, you're finally here. I'm glad. Tommy, what do you think of the moon? It's just dreadful, isn't it? I can say, it completely sucks ass. Or I think it's nice, actually. Uh-oh. Choices. One or two. One. It sucks. Two. I mean, it's nice. Poll. Okay, this has to be the quickest poll in the history of polls, chat. We have to completely just immediately go for it, alright? We cannot wait and sit there for like 20 minutes and be like, ah, now it's decided. Fly me to the moon and let me kick its fucking ass. Poll active. Alright, let's see what people are saying. People are saying... The majority is nice. What are people saying nice? Alright, guys. I think people want the nice one. Alright, so yep. 10-hour poll. Okay. Alright, well, so be it, guys. It's gonna be the nice one.
Be quiet. You are a mere tourist. You don't know a single thing about what it's like to live here. For millions of years, I've been here, a lonely god with no children to call my own. Let me introduce myself.
I am Eclipsion.
Well, nice to meet you. The god of this desolate rock. I know, I wish you told me about you earlier, but I kind of didn't pay attention because, you know, I was playing the Star Wars theme and I kind of lost all that stuff, so let me lie and say yes, I did pay attention. Ah, so there are still people on Earth who know of me and tell my fate. How very interesting, though it means little. No matter how many listen, my situation would remain the same. I'll still be stranded trying to squeeze blood from a stone.
Okay. Reading fail.
I'm sick, okay?
That's why I've taken things into my own hands. That's why I created Hell's Knight to harvest lives in your world.
Fate. Straight up Final Fantasy IX.
That's why I want the Earth to know the anguish of lifelessness. I exist only to create, but all I could do up until now was destroy. Everything is changing, though. I have finally managed to sow the seed of life. I finally ascended to a true god! Aren't you happy for me? I'm glad you got what you wanted, but because of you, everyone on Earth is either very sad or dead. You know, you got a good heart, Morbius. Exactly the kind of heart I'd love to tear out of your body. The kind of heart I'd love to use for my next creation. Let me show you the power of a real god! Prepare yourself, Morbius!
Literal Kirby boss.
Come forth, my true form!
Oh shit. Oh fuck.
Uh-oh. Now I shall confer upon you a rare gift. The honor of being slain by a god.
Oh. Cool.
No matter what you think you're capable of, your strength is that of a mosquito compared to me. Nothing you do here matters. Your fighting spirit is commendable. However, the sooner you accept your helplessness, the better. You can't do anything. You're no less of a puppet to me than Chibi was. This can only be fun for me for so long. Time to put you out of your misery.
Uh-oh.
Still surviving. Take this, my heavenly spear. Hasta la vista.
Okay. Well.
Whee!
Is this music from like... I don't know. Alright.
The Celestial Punch!
Pugnus Tranquilitatis.
Ooh!
How will the Joey escape from this one? I'm so low on health.
Oh shit! One more! Oh, save himself, okay. Do you see how futile all this has been? I want to destroy your spirit before I destroy your body. Even as you are ripped apart and scattered across the stars, you'll have not felt a tiny percentage of the pain I've felt. This is the end.
Fluctus Tormenticum.
Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. Oh. Oh, the spirit bomb. All power to the main cannon, fire!
Nani!
Oh my god! Potato made it! Ha! That wave motion gun ought to teach him a lesson! Belgus, you're alive? I went to hell and back. I won't bother you with the details. The most important thing is I'm here.
You were only able to catch me off guard because how little I regard you humans. Destroying both of you will be no more difficult than before. That's where you're wrong! I picked up some friends while I was away. Bring it in, guys! Cuckus! Hey, Morbius!
Still need the help of a cool bitch like me after all this time?
Ah, well, there's no shame in that! We gotta work together to save the world! Condom! I'm glad you're alive and not dead in a cave! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!
The wizard!
Fun to have you do that to you, Epsilon! Embrace me, don't you want to see your tale come to this? Morbius, I'm glad to see you have become a true hero! Your friends here support you, and the whole world believes in you! Yours will be surely be a story told for eras to come! Let me cast a rejuvenation spell! Good luck, Morbius!
Oh my god. Oh my god. Someone said it's the Rise of Skywalker all over again.
Are you lot quite done yet? Like hell we are.
Hey, hi, I'm Morbius. Check it out, I'm Haven's Knight now. I've been reborn.
Jeebe, you look very cool and golden. The hell did you even do to redeem yourself? You killed like a million people before.
I turned good. That's what I did. Anyway, Eclipsion is really strong, right? But with Holy's power, you can stand the chains. Take it, Morbius. Take the power and save the world.
Wow.
Sword imbued with holy power, gained the strength to kill God.
Go get him, Morbius. You can do it.
Show that haughty prick God and what we're all about.
The fate of all the investors you had now, Morbius.
Ruin their ass forever.
Nice friends you got there, Morbius, but nothing has changed. You and all your friends will die here and be forgotten forever as you drift away into the eternal cosmos. Show me what this so-called holy power of yours can do. I'll rebound your blade once more.
My fucking hand!
I have nothing more to say to you.
Well, I'll say this. I'll say. Okay. Yeah. I'll say this about the game. Even though this is kind of a joke, it's kind of pumping me up. I kind of like it a lot. Okay. What's this now?
No! It cannot be! Time to finish this! Let's do it!
That me.
Fusion Sword Formation A! Come, my friends! Oh my god! It's the man! I'm warming up! No! It cannot end this way! Final Holy Blade! Mode Change Attack!
Damn, dude.
Oh, my titties!
Eclipsion has been obliterated. You're victorious. Morbius level is maxed out.
Yes! We did it. Thank you all for coming. Bah, that was great.
Who'd have thought I'd lick their knife like a pervert type of woman like me would end up messing up a god?
Wow, this is so cool! We saved the Earth!
If not for Morbius, you'd still be trying to destroy the Earth.
Dee! Well, not all of you, though I do feel at least a little bit sorry for old Eclipsion.
Oh, great, here comes the Eclipsion apologist.
Eclipsion wanted above all else to see the moon bloom with life. This is what caused them to become twisted and resentful.
Oh, you do flatter me, Trobe.
You're alive?
But don't you know I am now a true god? Were your ears closed earlier when I announced that I have successfully created life?
I hadn't arrived here when you said that.
Okay. Well, you're hearing it now. The rejuvenation of the moon has begun. Eclipsion, you're still alive?
This feels familiar somehow. I can't put my finger on it.
I'd say we kill you more than anything else has ever been killed. Oh, please. I'm a god.
Oh, shit. It's fucking Vivek.
I will, however, concede that you slapped me silly, so I shan't fault you anymore.
Maybe I should just, like, completely ham it up. You know, I don't know, do like a Dio voice.
How can you kill a god? Besides, most of all, I'd like you to meet my creation. They are the end result of eons of a god's pain and tears.
Uh-oh.
The preparations are complete.
Magnificent. Excellent work, Doctor. Morbius, you have humbled me today. This whole time I felt angry, lonely, depressed. But until now, never so vulnerable. Thank you. Let us consider this a passing of the torch moment. You, a human, will be stamped out by your successor. My child, reveal yourself and destroy them!
Who could...
Oh, fuck! Oh, fuck! Who's that? Frankenstein! Oh, shit! No! Oh, my God!
Frankenstein, my most beautiful, perfect creation! Destroy Morbius! Burp. Fuck it. Oh my god. Frankenstein. Cannot believe it. The game was called Franken RPG and it actually had a payoff. This truly was a Franken RPG. Oh my god. This isn't looking good. Honestly, this Frankenstein is kinda cute. I'm going to try a change of tactics. Kiss.
What?
Oh. Oi. Oi, oi, oi. Oh no, he's hot.
Frankenstein, let's not fight anymore. I think instead we should get married.
Yeah. That's a good idea.
I like that idea a lot more than fighting. I now love you, Morbius. I also love you, Frankenstein.
What?
Got engaged to Frankenstein? Wow!
What?
I'm so happy for you both! Wow!
Wow, good on you, Morbius!
I have a lot of thoughts, but at the end of the day, I guess I've got no choice but to be happy for you. Congratulations!
This is good. I believe this action will bring more balance and harmony.
Oh, whatever. Sure, marry my Frankenstein, that's cool. Can I expect grandchildren?
Please, one step at a time. What is happening?
Oh, Reckless, I have a question. Which one of us will walk Dame down the aisle? Everyone's invited to the wedding. What's happening? Oi, oi, oi. Oi, oi, we walk in now. Oh, here's all the characters. This wedding isn't boring at all. I'm extremely awake for this. Okay, Beacon, I still don't know what it says, but, you know. I'm here to represent the Autonomous Children's Republic, formerly Kids Island, right? Here's the slimes. I'm not blushing, I just ate a lot of pepperoni. They have sure changed a lot from how they used to be. I'm a bit jellios. Do you think that if I were considered an acceptable life form by Eclipsion, I'd be the one marrying you today? Well, I'm happy enough for you. Welcome to the wedding zone, ham ass. Finally, I have a normal romantic life after hooking up with this leopard. Finding love is an important part of life for us leopard men too. I'm happy to say I've found love. I'm so glad my son-in-law is a leopard because I'm a bit of a cougar myself. Drink a big glass of wine. From the horror of all that has happened comes new love. That makes me hopeful for this world. Just because it is your wedding day doesn't mean that I won't kill you if you don't look at something in a way I don't like.
Thank you for...
I can't even voice act anymore. Okay, I'm just gonna... I thought Boonsh was like the boss, you know? I was wrong, you know? Thank you for bringing us the tale at close, Morbius. I didn't want my lord to experience even a moment of stress. Oh, it's magnificent. I wiggle my fingers with glee, clacking the gems on my rings so they may echo across the hall. Ha ha, with my unmatched perception, I always took you for a bit of a boring, simple servantile type. But you've gone and found someone just as dull as you. Bah, I am a jolly king full of jest. I'm greatly pleased, for though I am a great king, I love frivolities and grand occasions. Guys, holy shit, it's this guy again. He's outside the boundaries. I couldn't get him in the mountain, and now he's just outside again. Nothing gets to him. You've come so far, Morbius. With the story concluded, I'm going to become Marriage Counselor Mouse in case anything happens. Moon sand research in progress. I hope y'all consider my in for your honeymoon, Vinky Face. I didn't really put much effort into being a part of this adventure, but that's okay. Things seem to work out well. Who would have thought a humble fisherman like me would have gone to attend a space wedding? Did you know that scorpions are very sentimental in love weddings? I was gonna ask Dr. Hackle if he could split me in half so I could marry myself, but this works out pretty well. Throughout all this, I've learned a lot about myself. Oh, the boom. Quack, quack, let's light the spark of love. Yeah, baby. Hooray, I am a humbled to beast did invite to such a union. Well, Connor's back. For me, this has been a day of great lows and great highs. 3-3! We're not polyamorous, sorry. Oh, a threesome, little Manasha Tui. Gah! So you're marrying who I was supposed to be? Great! I hope someday I can find a lady blood man to be my wife. If not for killing us monsters, you may not have been strong enough to get here. Always remember this. Now that the world's at peace, I can use my smithing abilities to make nice things, like sharp metal toys for children! It was so fun to fly around with you. Wow, this is so beautiful! Thank you for believing in me, you're my friend Morbius. Oh, yeah. This is an extremely gross, ethically dubious wedding. So naturally, I think it's pretty awesome. Ah, I lost track of the story and I don't know what's happening. Oh my god. I'm ready.
Let it begin.
Well,
well.
Oh my god, here they come. Oi, oi, oi. Oi, 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 oi.
I'm a bit nervous. You got this. I bet you're really good at marrying me.
I'm proud of you, Frankenstein.
This is all beautiful. I'm going to throw up.
Well, without further ado, we are gathered around here today to celebrate the union between Morbius and Frankenstein. If anyone objects to this marriage, speak now, forever hold your peace.
Oh. I was gonna raise a fuss about this because a monster chopped my arm off, and I am pretty sure that Frankenstein's arm is my arm. But now that I'm here, I actually think this is pretty beautiful, so like, go ahead.
Okay, well, anyway, Frankenstein, do you accept Morbius to be your sweet best friend and to live together and marriage forever?
Me do.
And do you, Morbius, take Frankenstein to be your lovely forever pal and to hold him and love them for all time?
Yes.
Then by the power of God,
that's me.
I don't pronounce you married, and you may now kiss each other.
Thank you, everyone.
Wow. We truly was Frank and RPG all along. Wow. Wow. Yeah.
That was great. That was a silly little game. And I liked it a lot. Sorry, I was so sick throughout it, but you know, my voice was shot, but hey, you know what, I think, given how, you know, sick I am, I think it was a good reading and voice acting job anyway, so whatever. But hey, I thought this was fun. This is a really, really fun game. I can definitely see that some of the people that worked on Deltarune also worked on this. Special thanks me for making the game. Wow, I like it too. I liked it a lot too. King Klee was just Dungeon Man. I mean, come on. A lot of the music was just from, like, Battleship Yamato. There was a little Fist of the North Star. So it was a lot of, you know, it had a lot of JRPG aesthetics. Very Earthbound-y. And, but yeah, I thought this game was a fun parody. And there he is again! There's the guy! Like, he's gone! He's gone, the man gone. Morbius and Frankenstein. How oddly thematically fitting. Thanks for playing. Wow. That was a fun game, man. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it a lot. But wait, there's more. Uh-oh.
The moon. The eclipse.
Some said this is really as Final Fantasy IV, and it's great. Yeah.
What does it all mean? Zaendo?
I guess life is spreading on the moon now, huh? You know? Ah, so there's a hopeful, nice ending on top of the marriage as well. Huh. It's pretty damn cool. It's kind of like... Yeah. Yeah. But anyway, hey, I think that's the end of the game. I don't know if there's anything more to this. Is it? Until we see the question mark, right? You populated with Frankenstein. Alright. Well, everybody, I think the game here is over with, unless there's something extra to it. But I enjoyed this game a lot. It was a little fun one-off parody, and it had a lot of funny writing, and I enjoyed the tropes being, you know, satirically done, and it's pretty damn cool. But excellent game, man. Excellent game. That was thoroughly entertaining. That was thoroughly entertaining. I really enjoyed that game, man. It's a free game on Itch.io if you want to play it yourself and maybe find some secrets or Easter eggs that I didn't find. So there you go. But hey, very, very, very nice. Very nice. Anyway, guys, I'll be right back. Sit tight. And we've got more stuff coming up, so don't go nowhere. But once again, excellent game. I thoroughly like that. So absolutely. All right, I'll be right back, guys.